Hello students, welcome to a lesson through the virtual training center of the Brihan Mumbai Mahanagarpalika. My name is Shraddha teacher, and in this lockdown period, since we are not able to go to school children, we will be doing many lessons here online through the virtual class. So come on, let's proceed to our lesson for today. So children, let us complete what we started last time. So we were doing a lesson in standard 10th, and the subject was English. And if you remember, the name of the lesson was lesson number 4.5, The Old Man and the Sea. And children, we also saw that we did not read and try to understand the story as such, but we were doing a review of the book. So in actual case, we were talking about how to write a review for a particular book. So writing a review, we saw, is a kind of a skill in English. So when you learn how to write a book review, you could also then write a review for a movie or a review for a play, etc. So we looked at certain skills which were needed in order to write a review for a book. So today we will do part 2 of this particular lesson, The Old Man and the Sea, where we are going to look at all the exercises in the English workshop part. But before we go there, let's do a quick recap of what we did last time. If you want to go back to the lesson and do it in detail, then you can always go back and see the video which I have posted before this. So we did a book review, children, last time of the book The Old Man and the Sea, which was written by Ernest Hemingway. We also got a lot of extra information about the novels written by the same author. Then we looked at various novelists who are famous in America. After that, we talked about the various steps which are involved in writing a book review. Okay, we thought what things we should keep in mind if we write a book review and which things we should avoid. What are the important points that we should keep in mind when we write a book review? So all these things we did last time. So now let us start again by just doing a quick look at the story once again. Why? Because most of the questions that we will take now is based on the story. So let us look at a recap of the story, or the, you can say, the story in short. All right. So the story goes like this. There was an old and experienced Cuban fisherman. And he had a terrible bad luck. That is, he was going through a terrible phase of bad luck. And he was unable to catch any fish for 84 days. Now, this person, he had a young and devoted apprentice. Now, we discussed what the meaning of apprentice is. So, an apprentice is like a trainee, someone who's training to get into a particular profession. And so, he is observing a person who's already doing that job. And the trainee's name, the apprentice's name, was Manolin. But Manolin's parents were forcing him to work with some other fishermen, because they were under the impression that this old Cuban fisherman, he is himself not very successful. So what kind of tips will he teach our son? And of course, their fears were also not without any grounds. So the old man resolves to stay out further than all the other fishermen and attempt to catch the really big fish, because he wants to prove now to everyone that he himself is a very, very, you can say, accomplished fisherman. On the 85th day, he succeeds in hooking a marlin. Now, a marlin is a huge size fish with his bait. But the marlin is too strong for him and starts pulling the boat. So he starts tugging the boat along with him, whereas it should have been the reverse. The fisherman should have tugged the fish in. Okay, he should have pulled the fish in, but now the fish has started pulling the boat, actually. The Old Man and the Sea is a story of the old man's struggle with the marlin and his later battle against the sharks which are present in the sea. So this is about the story. So we have just very minimal characters. We do not have too many characters in the story. And of course, we have not read the entire novel. We have not read the entire story. We are just doing or reading the review of this particular book or this particular novel. Okay, so having said that, let us now proceed and let us look at the exercises which are based on the story. So read the passage and name the following. So now we just took a recap of the story. So now you have to read the passage again. That is, you have to open your textbook, go to this lesson, read the passage and try to find out the answers to this, and then come back and check your answers with mine. So who was the young and devoted apprentice? He was Manolin. And which was the place where Hemingway had experience of fishing? It was Cuban waters, or the waters around this particular place called Cuba. We also discussed when we did the book review that there was a lot of similarity between the author and the fisherman in the story. So both of them had done a lot of fishing around the Cuban waters. Hemingway was injured because of what thing during the First World War? So the author Hemingway was injured because of the shrapnel. Now what are shrapnel? Shrapnel are pieces of glass and metal, okay, which happens, which come out as a result of the bomb blast or result of the firing. So Hemingway was also injured because of the shrapnel. What is the language of the novel like? So what kind of language has the writer used? So the writer has used very simple and pithy language. So pithy language means to the point, okay, language which doesn't take you round and round, and of course simple, we know what it means. In his first reading, the writer left was, what kind of review did the writer have when he read the book for the first time? He was really unimpressed. That is, he did not think too much of the story written by Hemingway. He thought that this is just a book which is just not even ordinary. So he was not very impressed. Alright? So once you read the passage again and again, you will be able to arrive at many answers which are based on comprehension of the passage. Let's move on and let us do some more exercises which are based on the passage. So correct the following sentences using facts from the review. Now I am not going to do all of them. If there are four questions, I might do two, and then you have to do the remaining. Alright? So the first one, Manolin's parents insisted on his working with the same old fisherman. So now if you read the review, then you will know that the statement is false. Alright? So what was Manolin's parents' point of view? Did they want him to work with the same old fisherman? No, they did not. Manolin's parents did not want him to work with the same old fisherman. They wanted him to work with the young ones, with the ones who were successful. Alright. This novel is a pure fiction. So you have read the review. We have seen the review in short also on this video. So do you think that this novel is pure fiction? That is, there is no fact based in it? No, this novel is not pure fiction, because it is based on certain real events from Hemingway's life also. For example, he fought the World War, and he went fishing in the Cuban waters. So there are many things which are similar in Hemingway's story as well as the fisherman's story. Now, Hemingway's style of writing does not unfold the hidden meaning. So you have to find out the answer to this and write whether it unfolds the hidden meaning or it doesn't. So that does it mean that when you read the novel the first time, the second time, the third time, do you catch the same points or do you get some new meanings also? So read the text once again and try to write the answer to this. The relationship between the old man and Manolin is coarse. So what kind of relation is it? Now coarse is a kind of an adjective which we use for objects, okay? We say the surface is coarse, the surface is smooth. So coarse means not smooth. So come on, think about this. So what kind of relationship did the old man have with Manolin? Alright, so this is your job, this is your assignment. Let us move on. The line, I first read this novel years ago when I did not understand it at all and was left unimpressed. This line tells us about the book reviewer's opinion about the book. So when you read something for the first time, when you watch a movie, when you meet someone, you form an opinion about that particular person. Okay, it could be good, it could be bad, it could be based on your experience, it could be sometimes based on your expectations also. That is, you expect a movie to be very good or you expect a book to be very good, but it doesn't live up to your expectations. So your opinion could be based on any of these facts. Okay, so the book reviewer also had formed an opinion about the book. So now let us try to see what kind of expressions we can use in order to express your opinion. So imagine you're meeting someone for the first time. You are going to eat in a new restaurant for the first time. Someone has told you a lot of good things about that particular restaurant, that the food there is very good, it is awesome, and stuff like that. And when you go and eat there, does it match your expectations? So what kind of opinion will you express? How? What are the words you will use in order to express your opinion? So this is an exercise on how to use words in order to express your ideas. Okay, so in a way you can say that this is an exercise based on vocabulary. So see the first one. In my opinion, every hard-working person achieves success in life. So this is one way you can express your opinion. In my opinion, you can say, okay? And then you can say what you want to say. So here we have completed the sentence saying that every hard-working person, if you're hard-working, if you're willing to work hard, then you will definitely achieve success in life. Now that success may be huge, it may be mediocre, that is different. You might get it early, you might get it late, that is also a different thing. But succeed, you will. So that is someone's opinion about hard-working people. Let us try and give a few more opinions. I strongly feel that. So see, this is a very strong opinion. I strongly feel that. Let's see how I've completed it. You do good to others and good happens to you. So this is a strong feeling. I believe in this. That if I do good to others, then good will come back to me. Okay, let me take one more example and then I will leave you to complete the remaining lines. I wish I could. So now what is the meaning of this? I wish I could. Now this is exactly not an opinion, but this is a kind of a, you want something to happen. You're hoping that something good will happen. So I wish I could make people more aware about saving the environment. So this is my concern. I'm concerned about people not being worried about the environment, not saving the environment and causing harm to the environment. So I wish I could make people more aware about saving the environment. Okay, now look at the next two sentences. As far as I know, so you're expressing something which you know. You're sharing your knowledge with someone. As far as I know. Complete the sentence, see what words you can use over there. And the last one, I think. Now when you're saying I think, you're expressing your opinion. You are saying what you think. It may not necessarily match with what someone else thinks. Okay, children? So this is how you complete the sentences in order to make some expressions. So this is one more exercise. Exercise 4 from your English workshop part. Let's move on and let's do the next one. This is again an exercise based on vocabulary. So the review describes the struggle between the old man and the marlin and the sharks. Okay, so there were three, you can say, 4 points of focus over here. There was one old man and there was the marlin and there were some sharks also. Because the old man was trying to drag marlin in and the sharks were trying to eat marlin up. Ernest Hemingway's struggle against defeat or death. And noble struggle against destruction. So in a way, Hemingway's struggle is being portrayed through the old man. Even Marlin is trying to fight Hemingway, is trying to fight the old fisherman. Okay, the Marlin also doesn't want to die. He is also fighting on his own level against destruction. Alright, the old man is again fighting with destruction because he wants to somehow prove himself. the kind of failure that he's been having for the last 84 days has really bogged him down, and now he wants to prove a point. So he wants to succeed. All right? So somewhere or the other, these are all connected. So let us find out all the words from the text that are related to the word brave or courage. So in a way, you are looking at writing the synonyms or similar words to brave and courage, but you are going to search in the text. You are not going into the dictionary and looking at the words, but you are going to look into the text again and try to find out words which are related to brave or courage. So one word is strength. Let us look at a few more. So you have determination, which is one word, determination. Then you have endurance. So see, endurance is also a quality which shows that you are brave and you are courageous. Someone who is not brave will give up easily. Alright? So now this is again one more assignment for you. Go back to the text, read it carefully and try to write two more words over here. Alright? Come on, now let's proceed and let's go to the next exercise, which is a very simple one. You are just supposed to match the phrases. There are many phrases in this text, children. So try to match the phrases with their meanings. Okay? So part 1 of the assignment I will do. Part 2 of the assignment is for you. So what is part 2 of the assignment here? After matching their meanings, you have to make sentences of your own. So this is your job. Making sentences of your own is your job. So see, you have two columns. A, under column A you have the phrases, under column B you have the meanings. So you have a run of terribly bad luck, terrible bad luck, draws heavily on, struck a chord, in spite of, holding on. So let us read the meanings also and try to understand which phrase means what. Pause the video here and try to figure out the answers yourself. So run of terrible bad luck means a period of time when bad things happen. This happens to everyone in life. Just like you have the day and then you have the night and you have the day again. The time, the cycle of time keeps on changing. Sometimes are good, sometimes are not so good. Okay? Draws heavily on means makes use of something. So you have to put it into sentences, remember. Struck a chord means hit on a topic. In spite of means without being affected by a particular factor. And of course, the last one, holding on means to endure in difficult circumstances. To put up, to bear with difficult circumstances. So this, children, is the exercise. Half of the exercise, that is, you have matched. Now you have to make sentences of your own using these particular phrases. That is your assignment. So there are a lot of small assignments that you're getting in this lesson, children. So see to it that you do it. All right. Now we go to some grammar. So rewrite as directed without change of meaning in your notebook. So let us do some sentences based on do as directed. So each question is different. In every question you get a different instruction and you have to answer according to that particular instruction. So let's look at the first one. Hemingway's novel is based on real events. So now real events. So real there is one word which is the adjective and it describes the noun events. Now you have to convert the real word real to an adjective clause. That is, you have to make it a group of sentences. Okay, let's see how it is done. Hemingway's novel is based on events which are real. So see, here instead of using one word which is an adjective, we have used an adjective clause. We have learnt about adjective clauses, noun clauses, adverb clauses previously. Okay, we have done a video based on these clauses. So you can check back and find out which was the video and you can do a quick revision. Then he hooks a marlin, but the marlin is too strong for him. You have to rewrite the sentence, but you have to begin with the word although. So how will you write it? Although he hooked a marlin, it was too strong for him. So the marlin, he hooked it in, but it was too strong for him. Then the reader can read his work again and again and find new layers of meaning. So how will you change this sentence? On reading the work again and again, the reader can find new layers of meaning. That means if you read the book once, you will get a different meaning. You read it second time, you get another meaning. Okay, layers of meanings. The next one, as the novel progresses, the old man and the marlin are inseparably linked. So now here, progresses is the verb. You have to rewrite the sentence using progress as a noun. So there are certain words which are used as adjectives in some places, which are used as verbs in some places, which are used as nouns in some places. So come on, let us see how this verb becomes a noun. So the old man and the marlin are inseparably linked with the progress of the novel. So that means as the novel is progressing, as the novel moves ahead, the old man and Marlin are inseparably linked. Okay, so you see we have not changed the meaning. Moving on, the next one. Being strong, the Marlin starts pulling the boat. So you have to rewrite the sentence using and as a coordinator. So what is a coordinator? Something which joins two parts of the sentences. Okay, so the Marlin was strong and he started pulling the boat. Okay, simple. And the last one, when I first read this novel, I was unimpressed. So you have to use a but as a coordinator now. So I read the novel the first time, but I was unimpressed. Okay, so you see how we have done as the sentence has asked us to do. So that is do as directed. We have rewritten the sentences without changing the original meaning of the sentence. So that brings us to the end of this exercise. Now we come to the last exercise here in this lesson, where we will be writing the root word after dropping the prefix or the suffix or both. But before doing that, children, we are going to do a quick recap of what is the meaning of prefix, what is the meaning of suffix, and what is the meaning of root word. I have done this, I guess, with you in one of the lessons, but let us quickly take a look at this. So these are all affixes. Okay? Affixes. So affixes, prefix and suffix together, we call them as affixes. So what are affixes? They are a group of letters which are attached before or after the root word. So look at this word, unacceptable. In this, accept is the root word, the basic word which you will find in the dictionary. You have attached un before accept, so it is the prefix before the root word. You have added able after accept, so it is a suffix. So prefix before, suffix afterwards. And the word which is the original word, which has been changed or altered by adding the prefix and suffix, is called as the root word. Now before we go to the exercise, let us take one more look at this. So root words, a root word stands on its own as a word. You can find it in the dictionary. You can make new words from it by adding beginnings or endings. So beginnings are the prefixes and endings are the suffixes. For example, see, comfort is a root word. So You can add dis to it and write discomfort. You can write able to it and write comfortable. So this is how a root word can be modified by adding prefixes and suffixes in order to make a new word. Let us look at some examples here. So some of them I will be doing, the remaining you will have to do it yourself. So the root word, let us look at the first one. The root word is misinformed. So here, mis is the prefix, ed or ed is the suffix, and inform is the root word. You have unlikely, the second word. Un, un is the prefix, ly, ly is the suffix, and like is the root word. Let's come to the next one. Encouragement, where N is the prefix, ment is the suffix, courage is the root word. Okay? Let's take one more example. Disgraceful. Dis is the prefix, full is the suffix, and grace is the root word. So the remaining are for you to solve. Isn't it a very easy and simple exercise? So come on, try to find out the prefix, the suffix, and the root word in the other words given here. So that is one more assignment for you. Let's move on and let us look at the exercise, which is part of your textbook. So write the root word after dropping the prefix or suffix of both. Sometimes there is a prefix as well as a suffix. You have to drop both. So there are in total 10 words. I will do 5 for you, and the remaining 5 will be your assignment. Unable. So what is the root word? It is able. And you have dropped the prefix un. The second one, heavily. So the root word is heavy. See here, you have not directly added the suffix. Okay, there is some change which you have made to the root word to add the suffix. In unable, you have just directly added the un and the able has not changed anywhere. But heavily, if you notice, h-e-a-v-y, and you've added an I over there also. So it is heavily. Alright, come to the next one. Determination. Here also there is a slight change which has been made to the root word. The root word doesn't appear as it is. So determine, you have changed the E after the N to A, and then you have added the D-I-O-N. Determination. Next one, endurance. So the root word is endure. Finally, you have unimpressed, and the root word is impress. So I have knocked off the prefix un, and I have knocked off the suffix ed. So I have a new word here, impress. Okay, children? So this is about how you write a root word after dropping the prefix or the suffix. So this was all in the second part of the video, children. So in this video, we took a quick look at what we have done last time, and then we did certain exercises which are based on vocabulary, that is, we matched the phrases with their meanings. We also did some exercises on grammar, and here we did this exercise based on suffixes and prefixes, that is affixes. Okay, so this was all in this particular lesson, lesson number 4.5, The Old Man and the Sea, a book review. So children, wasn't that a wonderful video, and did you enjoy watching it? So if you want to watch more such videos in future, then please like this video and also subscribe to our channel, the MCGM Portal for Education, And also hit the bell button so that you get notified whenever I upload a new video here. Thank you so much for now. Let's meet again soon.